So guys, let us understand the concepts that we have discussed so far by actually doing the implementation. So we will going to implement our application protocol, which is nothing but we will going to implement our own HTTP web server. So HTTP web server is nothing but it's a application protocol. So we shall implement a simple client server program which implement our own application protocol. So let us learn how to implement application protocol by implementing our own minimal HTTP web server. So let us first understand how the HTTP web server actually works. So you can see in this diagram, the machine on the left hand side is actually the client machine, whereas the machine on the right hand side is actually the web server. Then when you browse the internet, how does the actually page loads when you click a certain link or when you browse certain websites? So let us go through the steps regarding how the HTTP protocol works. So the HTTP web server works as per the following steps. So the client, first of all, the client here is nothing but it's a browser. So the client prepares the HTML request message. So the HTML request message, something looks like this. It has a URL as well as the final resource which the client wants to fetch from the server. In this case, the final resource is the image of Acer laptops, that is acer.img, right? So the client needs to know the location of the resource it is trying to fetch from the web server. So csepracticals.com actually resolved to the IP address of the server machine, right? And on the server machine there is a folder images, inside that images there is a folder laptop, and inside that laptop there is a image file acer.img. So this entire path actually represents the location of a resource present on the internet uniquely. So here the resource is the image file. So this HTML request message is actually the application payload. This application payload is then pushed down the TCP/IP stack on the client side, right? So as the payload is pushed down the TCP/IP stack, the intermediate layers of the TCP/IP stack adds their own respective headers. Then client machine sends the HTTP request to the server asking for some information, that is asking for a resource. So you can see this HTTP request actually traverses through the internet, that is through L3 routing. And finally, this HTTP request reaches the server. When the server receives this HTTP request, this request moves up in the TCP/IP request on the server machine. So this is the step 4, and as the message traverses upwards in the TCP/IP stack on the server machine, each of these layers chop off their respective headers from the message, and finally the HTTP payload is delivered to the web server application running on the server machine. Then in the next step, the server do the processing as per the client request. So in the step 6, the server prepares the HTML response. So HTML response means it generates the HTML code. And this HTML code is what forms the reply to the HTTP request generated by the client. So this HTML response forms the application payload from the server side. Then this HTML response is pushed down the TCP/IP stack on the server side, and finally it is routed back to the client. Right? This HTML response is then pushed up in the TCP/IP stack, and finally the browser, that is the client, receives the HTML response that is generated by the web server. So remember, the HTML response was nothing but it was a HTML code, and our client is nothing but it is a browser. So browser understands HTML code. That is, using this HTML code which the browser has received in the HTML response from the web browser, the browser renders the page. So in the step 10, finally the browser renders the page, which is HTML code. So this is how the HTTP web server works. Now let us try to understand the implementation details of HTTP web server. So we have just discussed that the HTTP client sends the HTTP request to the server. So the HTTP client requests are of several types. The request that is generated by HTTP client are of several types. We will going to discuss two most commonly used ones. You should Google as HTTP request methods to learn for more of them. So there are not two, there are actually six or seven types of HTTP client requests. We cannot discuss all of them here, but we will discuss the two most commonly used HTTP requests. That is the GET request and the POST request. So after you understand the implementation of HTTP web server, you can browse the internet to learn other type of HTTP request, and you can implement them as a part of your coding assignment. But before that, let us build the basics. So what are actually GET requests? GET request, as the name suggests, the client is trying to fetch or get the data from the server. So example of GET request is like you are entering the roll number of the on the web page, and in return you are getting your exam result. Or the most simple GET request is that clicking the links and load or navigate to a new page. So all these are the example of GET request. GET requests are concerned with fetching the data from the server. The other type of request is the POST request. The POST requests are concerned with sending the data to the server, which will be eventually saved on the server side. For example, you are filling up the job forms. So you fill up all your details in the form and then you click submit, right? So all your details get saved on the server. Another example is uploading your resumes, and other examples are such that you are posting any comment or any post on certain social sites such as Facebook. So in all these examples, one thing is common, that you are sending the data to the server and the server eventually stores that data. So such type of request that is made by the HTTP client are called POST request. So when HTTP client sends the HTTP request to the server, client has to encode the request type in the request, right? Otherwise, how the server would come to know whether it is HTTP GET request or it is HTTP POST request? So next, let us discuss the exact format of HTTP GET request message. When HTTP client sends the HTTP request to the server, whether the request is a GET request or POST request, it sends the HTTP request in a predefined or standard format. So the HTTP request, that is the GET or POST or any other HTTP request, have to be in the defined or standard format. Just like you have IP header in the standard format, the HTTP requests are also have their own specific and standard format. So let us take an example of HTTP GET request. That is, how does HTTP GET request look like? So below is the HTTP GET request message contents. So you can see that the HTTP request looks like plain text or paragraphs. So it's a plain text. So this entire text in yellow is the HTTP GET request. The first line of the HTTP GET request is called request line. Why it is called request line? Because in request line, the client specifies the resource which it wants from the server. So here the first word is the get. That means it is a get request. The second part of the get request is the location of the resource which the client is requesting from the server. So you can see in this example, the client is actually requesting from the server the details of the student whose roll number is 10305042 and the department is CSE, that is Computer Science and Engineering. Right? So when the server receives this HTTP request, the server will parse this URL and come to know that what actually client is looking for. And the third part of this request line is the HTTP protocol version. Right? So you can see in this get request format, only what is important for you is to know the request line format. The rest of the details are actually automatically generated and added by the browser to your get request. Right? So we will learn in the practical session that how do you generate this HTTP get request using browser. So one thing to note here is that HTTP message types are simple plain text strings. So you can see it's a simple text. So all you need to do is to type out the request line in the browser, and the rest of the content in the HTTP get request is automatically added by the browser. So this content is auto-generated. Only the request line is what is required to be fed by the user using the browser. So going forward, the HTTP web server replies back to the HTTP client with the HTTP response. And this HTTP response is nothing but it is an HTML web page. So below is the HTTP response message format returned by the web server to the client. So you can see that the HTTP response that is returned by the web server to the client is also a plain text. Right? The first line says that it is 1.1 version of the HTTP protocol. Right? 200 is the code of success, that is the server is actually returning the result that was requested by the client. So 200 and OK represents the success, and the server can also specify its own name. So the name of the server is IIT student server. And the third field is actually the content length, which is 88 bytes. So this HTML code that is returned by the server is 88 bytes. Right? And the last field in the HTTP response header is the type of the content that is returned by the HTTP server. So here the HTTP server is actually returning a HTML code. Right? And the actual information that is returned by the HTTP server in request of the client is actually the HTML code. Right? So it is this HTML code which is rendered by the browser running on the client side. So you can see that the HTTP response that is generated by the server is also of text nature. And that is the reason that the HTTP protocol is called hypertext transfer protocol. Text means that the exchange of messages between the HTTP client and the HTTP server happens in the form of plain texts. Right? So all this is entirely a plain text. So maybe things may not be very clear to you at this point of time. So let us do the actual implementation of HTTP web server.